Hello, everyone. I'm Gan Tong from the National University of Defense Technology. I'm honored to have the opportunity to share work with you. Our work is an overview of Winograd convolution, so there is not much innovation. I will have another meeting to attend in a while, so the report time will not be too long. So let's get started. Convolutional networks belong to a class of neural networks that take the image as an input, subject it to combinations of weights and biases, extracts features and outputs the result. The name convolutional neural network indicates that the network employs a mathematic operation called convolution. Convolution is a specialized kind of linear operation. Convnets are simply neural networks that use convolution in place of general matrix multiplication in at least one of the layers. There are four main methods for calculating convolution. They are direct convolution, image to column based convolution, FFT based convolution, and Winograd based convolution. Let me first introduce these methods in turn. The first one is direct convolution. As shown in the animation, the blue squares represent the input matrix, the dotted squares represent the padding, and the gray squares represent the convolution kernel, and the green squares represent the output. The convolution kernel moves on the padded input bed, and the overlapping part is called a window or a receptive file. An element of the output matrix can be obtained by accumulating the value obtained after element-wise multiplication on the value of the window. This operation method is consistent with the definition of convolution. For the input matrix of M by M and the convolution kernel of R by R, the number of multiplications required is M times M times R times R. We can turn convolution into matrix multiplication, and the method is image to column. As the figure shows, for feature map of size H times W times C, first we shape K times C receptive file to column with K squared times C, then repeat for all columns to get K squared times C by N matrix. For convolution kernel, reshape each filter to K squared times C row, making D by K squared times C matrix. Then the convolution is transformed to a matrix multiplication. The result is D by N matrix. At last, the result is reshaped to output sensor. Because general matrix multiplication, aka GEMM, is highly optimized in many mathematical calculation libraries, this method can bring great performance improvements, but the number of multiplications is still not reduced. FFT-based convolution and Winograd-based convolution are belonging to fast convolution. Fast convolution is implementation of convolution algorithm using fewer multiplication operations by algorithmic strength reduction. Number of strong operations, such as multiplication operations, is reduced at the expense of an increase in number of weak operations, such as addition operations. These are best suited for implementation using either programmable or dedicated hardware. It has been known since at least 1980 that minimal filtering algorithm for computing M outputs with an R-tap FIR filter, which we can call FMR, requires M plus R minus one multiplications. So the standard algorithm for F23 uses 2 times 3 equals to 6 multiplications, Winograd documented the following minimal algorithm as shown in the slide. This algorithm uses just four multiplications and is therefore minimal by the formula. It also uses four additions involving the data, three additions and two multiplications by a constant involving the filter. The sum of G0 plus G2 can be computed just once, and four additions to reduce the product to find the result. Winograd faster filtering algorithms can be written in matrix form as this. A minimal 1D algorithm FMR is nested with itself to obtain a minimal two-dimensional algorithm FM times MR times R like this. Now, algorithms for FM times R and R times R can be used to compute coordinate layers with R times R kernels. Each image channel is divided into tiles of size M plus R minus one times M plus R minus one with R minus one elements of overlap between neighboring tiles, yielding P tiles per channel. The convolution is then computed for each tile and the filter combination in each channel, and the results are summed over all channels, and the number of multiplications becomes M at R minus one times M at R minus one, greatly reduced compared to direct convolution and image to column based convolution. The four stages of Winograd convolution is shown in the figure, includes input transformation, kernel transformation, element-wise multiplication, and output transformation. And next, we talk about the generalization of Winograd convolution. The introduction of Winograd convolution is a milestone, but the convolution only supports two-dimensional convolution, operates with r equals to 3 and r equals to 2. And the tile size does not exceed 6, but this is far from satisfying the various type of convolution operators in modern CNNs. So there are many subsequent studies that generalize Winograd convolution to various types. They extended Winograd's support for convolution to large arbitrary kernel size, large tile size, n-dimensional convolution, straddled convolution, dilated convolution, and transposed convolution. The Winograd convolution algorithm family is based on the Chinese reminder theorem. On polynomials, we can construct different polynomials to transform the tensor into different domains. Existing researchers generate transformation matrices by constructing high-order polynomials, and research try to transform tensor into complex number domains. The reminder system and Fermat number transformations have also been introduced into Winograd family convolution. There is also research using Winograd convolution to replace the convolution implementation in strengthened algorithm. Some researchers apply Winograd convolution in Ethernet completely using additions instead of multiplications. Pruning is an effective technique commonly used in CNN optimization. Pruning is mainly used to prune the weights of convolution operator in CNN and the weights that have little effect on the output will be set to zero. Pruning can greatly reduce the size of model and the amount of calculation. Some researchers proposed to apply pruning on Winograd convolution. They applied a ReLU after the input transformation to obtain a sparse Winograd domain tensor. At the same time, the transformed convolution kernel is pruned to obtain a sparse Winograd domain convolution. At this point, the two tensors in the calculation stage have become sparse tensors. There are also other methods for pruning, such as using pruning instead of ReLU or changing the position of pruning. It is another common method in CNN to sacrifice the precision and reduce memory footprint and computational efficiency, changing the parameters of CN model from a 32-bit floating point number to a 16-bit floating point number, or quantizing it to an 8-bit fixed point number or even lower precision. Can compress the model and improving computing efficiency without losing the accuracy of the model. There is also some very important work to optimize the numeric stability of Winograd convolution. The ratio of the largest element to the smallest element of the Winograd transformation matrix increases exponentially with the increase of the tile size, which brings great instability to the calculation. Some researchers have used high-order polynomials to generate transformation matrices with smaller transformation errors. Some researchers have proposed to training to solve the accuracy problem. Some researchers have also proposed a decomposition of a method to decompose large convolutions into small convolutions to maintain numerical stability. Now that we have a more efficient convolution, it will naturally be applied to various platforms. There has been a lot of work applying Winograd convolution on platforms including CPU, GPU, FPGA, etc., especially FPGA. Due to the operational characteristics of Winograd convolution and four separate stages, it is more advantageous to implement and optimize on FPGA. I will not talk about the specific implementation here, and those who are interested can read the relevant literature cited in the paper. It is worth noting that because Winograd convolution brings high performance and real time, there are also many implementations on IoT devices. The real-time performance brought by Winograd convolution has brought great impetus to the implementation of real-time scene. There have been some studies using Winograd convolution to achieve high-performance real-time artificial intelligence applications. Some researchers have implemented a face recognition system using high-efficiency hybrid convolution on FPGA, achieving a performance improvement several times that of GPU. Action recognition based on three-dimensional Winograd convolution was also implemented with only 6.6 milliseconds of demonstration. There are also implementations in real-time super resolution for 2K resolution video, up to 60 FPS stable performance. This above is all the content of my report. Due to the tight schedule, I can't cover everything. If you have any questions,